what's up with you guys, bro? It's Fresh Boy D-Lo here with my brother Brian, aka my manager. We over here at Guaranteed Studio. Just got it in. Mixing up some songs, about to drop some shit on the way. New heat, y'all ain't ready, period.
Y'all ain't ready.
But yeah, we finna get this shit started. I knew I wanted to start rapping when, like, because I've always been writing and shit. Since I was a kid, I always used to freestyle my uncles. Like 4 years old, bro, I used to be a little rapper. I used to be dissing my sister, be like, she tell on me too much, she a snitch, all that other stuff, bro. I was gassing on everything I could when I was a kid. And ever since then, I mean, I've tried to write poems. I've always been a good writer, period, on everything I do. Like, so, I mean, at one point, you know, I just went through something and I started writing and I was like, okay, this is a good shit. I felt the energy. And then I seen my homie Shane with Kid Lucid at a football game, and I walked up to them and they said they had a studio. So like I never knew how to start my rap shit. But you know, they gave me a little session at their studio. And then from there I was just feeling the energy, everything. I feel like it was the way. I feel like it was just the way. I really hopped up in there, started flowing. I just felt like it was really the way, bro. Like, to be honest, I never felt the energy like that, or no energy like that. So
it felt like
I just got inspired by that shit and just went with it. At that time, I just knew like if for a business perspective, that's the way to go. You know, promoting myself as a person, I want to get out there and I want to be an influence to a lot of things. Change a lot of things. The vibe that I want to promote. It's unstoppable. That's all I gotta say. It's finna be unstoppable. Who are my biggest influences? I'm not even finna lie, man. I don't know why, but this one rapper, Sacramento rapper, Drill Gates. I don't care about nothing he affiliated with, none of his little games, bro. Some people don't mess with people because what they affiliated in. But it's like, bro, just listen to people's art. Just listen to the music. Trip off that shit, bro. And he got his own flow, his own. You get caught up in the beats. If you get caught up in his flows, it's everything. You be feeling like just the flow and shit. And that's what a lot of different rappers from Sacramento. It's a lot of different people that you just sit there and you actually listen to, and you just like you just feel the vibe from the music. It feels like it feels good.
You can relate to.
You can relate to it, bro. Yeah, you can actually relate to it. And there's a lot of, there's hood aspects to it, but everything got a certain goal, bro. We ain't out here trying to kill people. Like, don't be with that shit. Don't do that. I'm influenced by something else. Let's get into the bag.
Yeah,
sure. You know, just respect people, bro. Yeah. Be in your space at the same time, though. Don't be too extra on none of that. I'm inspired with people who humble themselves or just promote themselves in that way. And I was inspired by Drill Gates when I listened to his lyrics. It just was simple, smooth, all of that. I'm not really inspired by that many people like that. Like, there's a lot of different people whose music really don't sound like up to point, but everything got a message, man. And I just really fucked with his message. If I can collab with one person in the industry, there's so many people in the industry.
Everybody can count.
But I'm not even gonna lie. To be so solid with you, I feel like I gotta say Quando Rondo, bro. I gotta say him, cause I feel like just his rap style, along with like some mood I can catch up in that shit. But if I drop something, just the whole feel of it, like the whole beat and shit, like with those lyrics, if I did a feature with him, that shit would slap. That's all I gotta say. I put in work on that one. Y'all can expect my next song sometime around like November or something, because I'm gonna start November around Thanksgiving or something, because I'm gonna start coming up here all the time, trying to record as much as I can, get my songs out there, whatever, post, give somebody something to listen to and get inspired by, get on my movie. They can expect songs coming from me, because that's what I'm gonna be working with. So that's that, bro. You come up to Guaranteed, they're gonna get the right period. I have plans. Yes, I have plans for dropping something like an album, an EP coming soon, sometime in the future. I really want to focus on these little single songs real quick. Get those out the way, get it like five, six videos up there. See where those take me, promote my shit, get a cool little fan base going. Get up there, get my bag right. I mean, anytime in the future, during 2019, I'll be dropping the album or EP. I'm shooting for like February to get my album or EP out there. Something, some messes, like something smooth. Shit changes, something like that. Like just an album, bro. Just how like, just childhood shit. Anything I can catch on, anything I can tell a story to, just know that the album or the EP is gonna be a story. My biggest challenge in music, honestly, okay, so you don't wanna sound too stuck up, you know? I catch myself being careful of sounding too fucked up, like I don't care about nothing. Cause there is emotions you don't wanna sound like you just that type of person. I don't wanna sound like I'm an ignorant person, cause I'm not. And I really don't care how people view my music. Is individual opinions, but for all, you know, keeping a solid image for yourself, a respectable image for yourself, and maintaining that is the hardest thing that I feel like I'm gonna come across. I'm gonna be challenged. There's gonna be things that trying to get me out of my character, people who trying to beef with me, anything. I just kind of gotta ignore it. That's gonna be the biggest challenge, is just sticking to yourself, sticking to your lane, your goals, period. How many songs do I have saved up in vaults? I don't know, I got like 3 saved, undropped, unreleased songs in vaults. And
you got like new ones every day.
I got new ones like every day. And notes, you said? Notes. Songs saved up in my notes. Like if I'm writing. Okay, in my notes, bruh. I got like a new verse every day. A new verse every day. That's what you wanna do too. If you rapping, you wanna get them verses. You wanna work with a verse whenever you in class, bro. If it's in your head, pull out that paper.
Write it down.
It's a whole culture. Pull out that paper, start writing your shit down. If you got your phone, grab your phone, start writing, whatever.
If you think about something, just let that shit out.
Let that shit go.
Let it go.
Hey, so say if I'm getting signed for the M's, bruh. I'm getting signed for meal tickets, bruh. I want to run up like a business. That's a big purchase. It's a business, cause I mean, I'm gonna give me a little car or whatever house I can afford, just because I want, you know, whatever I get signed to reflect success. I want to feel my success. You know, it's not about the symbolic figures or nothing like that, but just to get that house, them cars, that life. ATVs, whatever.
So you wanted is
ATV, yeah, jet skis, boats.
That's what everybody wants.
I don't care, RVs, camping trips, all of that shit. I'm gonna really be in so much different shit, but my big purchase is gonna be like a business, like a barbershop / shoe store / shit. As a matter of fact, bleep, coming soon. I don't care. Y'all ain't even need to hear that idea, but you know I'm gonna come with it. Honestly, if I blew up tomorrow, and if I just became a big superstar, bro.
Like
what
M's.
I mean, just M's. If I got M's followers, M's on all my social media accounts, SoundCloud, Instagram, YouTube. If I got them million subscribers and shit, if I'm up there with it, I'm honestly gonna stay in school, because I feel like education is key. You know, I want to be able to go to college if I want to go to college for something. If I need to do anything in life, I don't want nothing holding me back. I just want to get, because, I mean, if I'm at a position where I'm probably going to most likely be in a position where I regret that shit later on in life. If I don't finish school, that's going to hold me back on a lot of shit. So, you know, if I blew up tomorrow, I stay in school.
Ooh.
All right, so from when I first started, and my whole stuff has changed dramatically, because from when I first started, I was wanting to be like everybody else, or not really, but I'd always listen, and then my songs were so diverse, because one minute I'd be listening to NBA YoungBoy, be like, oh, I'm finna make a song like this, or one minute, you know, I just changed the mood, but my flow and all changed, because I wanted to be myself. How do you think that
back then you were just still looking for your own flow?
I was still looking for my own flow.
You was looking for your style that you develop by now?
Just, I developed, you know, this mindset behind my stuff. I know how I want my shit. I know the moods that I want to present. The moods that I feel when I'm writing, I just put that shit on the paper. And I didn't do that from before. You know, I didn't put my moods on the paper. You didn't feel my mood in my writing. You just felt like lyrics. It just felt like dead. So it really changed because I started showing more emotion, because I started feeling my craft more. I started knowing my abilities and knowing what I could do with what I had. So, I mean, my biggest change is just my flows, my emotions behind my music. What I sound like now is way different from when I started. My city, honestly, I got a lot of people out here who I'm already known. Once I start making a big name for myself, they gonna mess with me. But I'm not even gonna lie, just because I know Sacramento, Sagtown, just because I know people out here, they're not gonna mess with me. All I gotta say for that and to them is like, I'm in my own lane, bruh. I'm gonna keep it pushing. I don't care. I'm not gonna address none of y'all. Because you guys, you first off, cloud chasers, you got that shit all the time, all day.
Cloud demons.
I know for a fact that I'm a supportive type person. I know for a fact that I'm genuine. Alright? So, I mean, my city gonna support me. I know they gonna support me for sure. If there's haters, I know most of my supporters is gonna be like, bruh, you're hating, period. I don't feel like I got no problems with nobody. Yeah, I feel like my city would really mess with me. They would want to see me win. Okay, so currently worldwide, I feel like it's very diverse. I feel like there's a lot of influences coming from different rappers that's unhealthy, ungenuine, not real. There's a lot of fake people who do it for the fame. If they're doing it for the fame, they're not genuine. I don't do this shit for money, fame, nothing. I do this because I got a lifestyle that I want to live out. I'm my own person. I got my own dreams. I got my own goals. I got my own dedications. It drove me to this. If I'm going to do this, I'm going to do this. You know, who doesn't seek success for their life? I feel like the baddest influence and the diversity in this rap scene today is just weird, to be honest. I feel like, you know, you got a lot of people wanting to be like other people. You got kids acting like, you know, a lot of rappers, that's bad. I don't look at that as being a good thing. You know, kids out here wanting to act up, trying to act like Trippy Red. Trippy Red, a cool rapper, he a cool person. But if you got kids doing it, I feel like that's messed up. The influences are in the wrong place. Actually, from when I was a kid, I grew up in Merced. I didn't really grow up in Sacramento. You know, I'm never gonna claim that I'm from Sacramento. They're gonna know I'm from Merced. I mean, even that, the city didn't do anything for me. Merced didn't do nothing for me. I learned a lot there. It's my childhood. I learned a lot from Sacramento. And that's the person I am now. It's just influences from all different places. The city I grew up in, it was like, it was ghetto. It was good. But like from one of my songs, I was like, from the struggle, you ain't been what I've been through. So when I tell you no, I don't want you pressing issues. But yeah, my song, that shit was slapping, bro. What I meant is, like, I came from the struggle. I didn't have it easy growing up. I didn't get anything I wanted. You know, I grew up in studios, studio apartments, two-bedroom apartments. When I came up to Sacramento, my life changed. My parents got good jobs. And that's when my parents started to come up. And that's just what I formed from now. How I feel about the city I came from is, like, there's a lot of good memories, a lot of family up there. I love my city. I love Merced. And that's just how I feel. Pretty soon, I'm gonna drop a music video. My first music video. Actually, I'm gonna drop this one that I recorded today with the music video sometime in November. That's gonna be November, December, and that's gonna be the staple to like my first beginning. I'm trying to start a new wave. It's gonna go crazy. The whole music song, the music video, all of that.